They told you it's normal. They even told you it's healthy. Well, they were wrong. Masturbation isn't self-care. It's self-sabotage. Every time you open a tab, you're not just wasting your time. You're weakening your brain. Today, I'm exposing the 10 biggest lies that you've been sold about masturbation. And I'm going to show you the neuroscience that proves it's keeping you anxious, unfocused, and emotionally numb. Let's talk 10 myths plus the 10 neuroscience truths. Myth number one, it's a healthy stress relief. Wrong. It's a chemical escape and it's wrecking your nervous system. You feel stressed, overwhelmed, anxious. So you reach for a fix. That easy fix is a quick hit of pleasure. Masturbation, porn, dopamine. For a moment, your brain feels good. But what happens next? Crash. That dopamine spike that you feel gets followed by a cortisol collapse. Your stress hormone tanks, then it rebounds harder than before. Now your nervous system is yo-yoing between fake highs and real exhaustion. Worse, you're training your brain to cope with stress by avoiding it. Instead of solving the problem, you're hitting the escape button again and again and again. Over time, your brain forgets how to handle discomfort. All it remembers is the shortcut, and the shortcut becomes the prison. Chronic avoidance, zero resilience, and a mind that taps out the second it gets hard. Myth number two, it helps you sleep. It doesn't help you sleep. It sedates you, then it traps you. Yes. Ejaculation does trigger a prolactin dump, and that makes you feel drowsy. Drowsy isn't rest. That's your brain tapping out. But here's what no one tells you. When you keep using masturbation as your bedtime ritual, you're teaching your brain that orgasm equals sleep, but they are not the same. And now, your brain doesn't know how to shut off without it. What started as just stress relief has become a full-blown dopamine dependency. You've hijacked your natural circadian rhythms. Those are the very things that are supposed to regulate your hormones, your energy, your sleep, your mood tanks because of it. Now, take away the screen, take away the hit. What are you left with? You probably know this. Insomnia, agitation, withdrawal, a brain that doesn't know how to rest. Myth number three, it boosts your sexual performance and satisfaction. No, it kills it, silently and systematically. You think all this practice is making you better in bed. It's not. It's doing the exact opposite. Every time you use porn, you're training your brain to respond to fake bodies, fake sounds, and fake scenarios. You're not building stamina. You're building a dependency on isolation, control, and fantasy. So when you finally get into bed with someone you care about, your brain flatlines. Porn-induced ED is real. It's not just psychological, it's neurological. And now the same thing that was supposed to boost your game is making it so that you can't even play. Myth number four, it doesn't impact your motivation. This is the most dangerous myth of all. It doesn't just waste your time, it kills your drive. You think you're just blowing off steam, a little release, a little escape, but behind the scenes, something way darker is happening. Your brain is being reprogrammed to choose short-term pleasure over long-term purpose. Every time you flood your system with dopamine, you're weakening the prefrontal cortex in your brain. That area is associated with focus, drive, goal setting, discipline. And here's the brutal truth. Your brain can't chase greatness, and instant gratification. It has to choose. And right now, you've trained it to choose the shortcut again and again and again. The more you scroll, the more your brain learns. Why chase legacy? Why chase purpose and passion? You can get a fake win in just 5 minutes. Myth number 5, masturbation is better than sex. This is a whole different set of brain chemicals. With porn and masturbation, you get dopamine. With real sex, you get vasopressin, you get oxytocin. These are the chemicals that are associated with emotional bonding, with satisfaction, with connection. You get the afterglow. So yeah, solo release might feel intense for like 10 seconds, but then emptiness, numbness, regret. Your brain doesn't feel loved. It doesn't feel connected. It actually doesn't even feel satisfied. It just feels used. Why? Because you just stimulated intimacy without actually getting any. You just missed out on the very chemicals that build trust, affection, emotional grounding. And the more you do it, your brain begins to prefer the fake version. It's easier, it's faster, it doesn't require presence. But easier isn't better. If you keep feeding your brain counterfeit connection, don't be surprised when real intimacy feels boring, or it might even feel out of reach. You're not just giving your brain pleasure, you're training your brain to settle for less and call it more. Myth number 6, it's not addictive. If you can't stop, it's not just a habit, it's a hijack. You've been told it's natural, it's just part of life, it's fine. But here's the uncomfortable truth. Your brain doesn't care if it's a drink, if it's a joint, if it's a screen filled with softcore porn. It responds to one thing, dopamine. Compulsive masturbation lights up the exact same brain circuits as a drug addiction. The limbic reward loop, where cravings are born, where tolerance builds, where self-control gets overridden by the urge to feel a little bit better fast for a little while. This is addiction. Escalation, tolerance, compulsion. You need more content, more novelty, more edge, just to feel something. If you keep pretending it's not addictive, you will never see the cage that you're already in. Number 7, it makes you happy. Every time you chase that dopamine hit, you're borrowing true happiness from tomorrow to feel okay today. And eventually you run out. Your brain stops producing dopamine naturally. You feel flat, disconnected, unmotivated, emotionally dull. That's called anhedonia, the inability to feel joy. It's not just a bad day. It's your nervous system breaking down. Now, real life feels boring. Conversations feel heavy. Social situations feel overwhelming. You isolate, you numb out. And what do you turn to when the emptiness hits? Masturbation. Again, it becomes your escape. But here's the trap. The escape is fueling the very pain that you're trying to avoid. It's a feedback loop, a negative feedback loop. It goes like this. Depression, masturbation, more depression, repeat. And the longer you stay in this loop, the more you just convince yourself that this is just who you are now. Myth number 8, it has no physical consequences. If you think it's just mental, think again. Your body is paying the price every single time. And here's the part that nobody mentions. Your brain and nervous system run on fuel. And every time you ejaculate, you're depleting yourself of two critical resources. One, acetylcholine, the neurotransmitter that's responsible for focus, clarity, memory, zinc. It's essential for nerve function, hormone balance, energy. Chronic masturbation doesn't just waste time. It's draining your brain of its raw materials. What does that look like? Brain fog, physical fatigue, irritability, weak stress tolerance, low drive. Sound familiar? That's not just life. It's neurochemical deficiency. Myth number 9. Everybody does it, so it must be fine. Just because something is common doesn't make it healthy. It makes it accepted dysfunction. Now, this isn't a moral situation. It's about your brain health. Neuroscience doesn't care what's popular. It cares about how your brain responds to stimuli over time, in patterns, under stress, when the pressure builds. And here's the truth. If you're feeding your brain a steady diet of cheap pleasure, if you're rewarding it for doing nothing, if you're letting a screen substitute for discipline, intimacy, ambition, then you're not optimizing for success. You're optimizing for stagnation. Myth number 10, masturbation doesn't affect your brain. That's a lie, and here's the science to prove it. Every time you watch porn and masturbate, your brain gets flooded with dopamine. It's the same spike that happens with a hit of cocaine. But here's the catch. Your brain doesn't treat that hit like a one-time thing. It starts building a reward loop around it. Scroll, click, release, repeat. Do it enough times, you're literally training your brain to chase synthetic pleasure instead of real intimacy and connection. This isn't harmless, it's neurological sabotage. Here's the truth. You've been lied to, numbed out, conditioned. You're not broken, my friend. You've been miswired, wired in the wrong direction. And the same brain that was wired to chase artificial pleasure can be rewired to chase connection, passion, purpose. This, my friend, is your line in the sand. No more excuses. No more blind scrolling. No more surrendering your masculinity, your focus, your future to an algorithm that is conditioning you to be weak. Start your brain reset right now. Hit subscribe. Commit to 7 days. Click the video that's appearing on the screen right now. Stay with me. Step into the work. Because you're not just quitting a bad habit. You're actually reclaiming your life and elevating your mind over explicit matter.